Hi everyone, this is Ken, and thanks for visiting the Busy Dad's Workshop YouTube channel. Today we're going to talk about workshop lighting. In the workshop, lighting is probably the most important aspect about working in a workshop, and you want to have good lighting for all your different projects. And what we're going to do today is upgrade the lighting that you see behind me, which is just a double fixture, a 4 foot T12 fixture. I'm going to take that out and we're going to put in two T8 fixtures. So let's get started. Okay, so the first thing that needs to be done is you have to figure out where you want to put your lights. And I have some heating ducts that you can see here that are causing an issue with this section of the workshop, which is going to be my finishing and assembly area. And so what I had to do was back off from this heat duct here about 4 or 5 inches so I could place the first light. And then the second light I just moved here 43 inches back from that, which gives me a good distance here between the two lights for the area that I'm going to be working on. All right, so the first thing you want to do is make sure that the power is completely turned off. The last thing you want to do is shock yourself here with a project like this. Now, as you can see, there's already some wire hanging here. I have already started this project with the other side of the workroom. Unfortunately, Murphy's Law has kicked into place and I ran out of wire before I could actually finish this project. So luckily, you know, you can run down to the home improvement store and actually pick up a 15-foot section, which is good enough for me to run from this section across the joists here over to the next location. So it's easy enough to just, you know, open this bag up and roll out the cable. Now what I like to do is straighten the cable out for a short section like this. Makes it easier that you don't have to deal with all of the kinks. And then you want to run through your Romex connector. I like to make them equal length as you pull them through. And then lock up the Romex connector. Now the next thing you want to do is strip the wire. I usually strip it out, you know, 4 to 6 inches back to give me enough room to work with here. Of course, inside a 14-2 wire, you have two wires. One's black, one's white for neutral, and then you have the ground wire that's in the plastic paper here. Just cut that off the back. And strip off about 3/8 of an inch or so of wire. Now, when it comes to actually joining the wires together, you know, everybody has pretty much seen one of these guys. These are the wire nuts. You put the wires together, twist them up, and you're done. Now, what I found recently at the big box stores, and this is by Ideal, they're called Ensure. These things right here, they come in a bag. This is a bag of 100. You know, you can also give blister packs of 10 pieces. It's a little spring connector that you can actually just push the wires in, and you don't even have to twist them together or mess around with holding them all together so you can thread the nut on. It makes it really easy. So this particular version here is a 3-position connector. So it allows me to bring my feed line in, my branch circuit, and then also my power wire all in one terminal. So it makes it real easy. So all you do, stick one wire in, the next, and the next, and it's done. Now these connectors are good from 12 gauge to 20 gauge, so any of the wires that are inside, you know, cabinet or lighting like this, or these branch wires that are 14-2, it's really easy to all connect it all up into one. So I'll go ahead and do the next one here. So that already takes care of my power wire. Now all I have to deal with is grounding.
you want to make sure that you ground every electrical connection that you make. And what I like to do is twist the wires together, make sure that they have a nice tight connection. And then add a crimp sleeve. So a crimp sleeve is nothing more than a little brass ferrule. You just slide these right on and you crimp it down nice and tight. This just makes sure that nothing goes anywhere. Give it a nice tight squeeze. Trim the excess of the shorter wire. Give it a little hook at the end. And then just ground it right to the housing. So that finishes the wiring for the first light here, and you can put the cover back on, put the lights on, and then put the diffusion cover on. And then what we can do is go to the next wire. Now, when you're running from one light to another light, you want to make sure that when you're going along a floor joist like this, or a ceiling joist, what you want to do is put wire staples along the path of the wire to make sure that they stay secure. This keeps it from drooping down or getting in anybody's way. Now that we have the wire in the second housing right over here, we can go ahead and finish wiring this light up. Now just once again to show you how everything gets wired, you use those push-on connectors, white to white, and black to black. And then since we only have one ground wire, all we have to do that is put that to ground. And at this point, the wiring is pretty much complete. All we have to do is put the covers back on, the bulbs in, and the diffusion covers, and you're done. Okay, so we have the cover back on. It's just a squeeze fit cover, and now to put the bulbs in. Now, as far as bulbs are concerned, there's a lot of different bulbs that are out there, and there's a lot of different types of lights out there. These are T8 fixtures, and they are 32 watt bulbs. Now, there's daylight, there's cool white, there's warm color lighting, and what I found is that either the soft white's not enough light or the daylight is just too harsh. So the cool white seems to give the best color rendering and not be overbearing on the eyes. So these bulbs just are real easy to put in because these new housings have a plastic ring in place that keeps the bulb from going in the wrong way. And there's just a click, and then the bulbs are in. And that's it. Okay, so here we are. We have both lights put in, and I have to think that it's a lot better than what it was. And it's given me a lot of great light for right here in my assembly and finishing area. And as you can see, I already have another project going here. So hopefully you guys like this short video. And you will subscribe to my channel and leave a comment. I'd appreciate it. Thanks.